Hello, good morning students. Welcome back to the tutorial session of MS Excel, okay? So in my previous sessions, I have already discussed the entire functionalities of the Home tab. Right? Now, in this session, I will explain the next tabs. So let's start with the Insert tab, okay? So first of all, we need to know what is Insert tab. As you might guess, this one handles anything you might want to insert into a document, such as charts, pivot tables, tables, pictures, text, word art, etc. Okay. So first is in the Insert tab, first is pivot table. Now the definition, a pivot table is a table of statistics that summarizes the data of a more extensive table. That means it's a data summarization tool which are used to summarize, sort, reorganize the stored data. Okay, so you can just pause the video and note it down. I will explain pivot table in a next session briefly. Okay. So next is table. Table is just let me show you. I am selecting the entire data. Just selected the entire data and clicking on the table. Before that, just I am showing the data range. The data range is A1 from A1 to, that is A1, okay, and to F16, to F16, okay. So the data range is A1 to F16. Now, clicking on the table, data range is A1 to F16, and my table has headers definitely, and I'm clicking OK. So we got the tabular structure of this data. Now from here you can change the styles and the design of the table. Okay. Just have a look. Okay. So next thing is illustrations. From illustrations, you can add pictures, smart arts, you can add shapes or anything to your workbook. Okay, just let me show you. Just click on pictures and it taking me to the library. Now from where I can derive any picture to my workbook. Just click on insert. Have a look. Okay. So you can add the picture designs over here, just like bordering it, or you can add any types of design. Okay. So just a moment. Let me delete it. And now shapes, you can add any type of shape over here from this icon. Okay, you can also add smart art, or you can add online pictures if you have internet connection in your desktop or laptop. Okay, so just let me delete it. Now the next group is chart group. I will discuss about the chart group in my session number 6. Please watch it very carefully. Okay. Okay. The next is, just a moment. The next is link. Just click on this link. From this option, you can link any file, document, or any website with your Excel file. Okay. A file I have already made before. To open that file, here we can use this link. Suppose I have already made the theory, this MS Word file. Okay. Now I'm getting that file by clicking. Okay. So just click on it, this hyperlink, and this file has been opened. Okay, it's opened now. So this is by this icon, you can add any hyperlink in your workbook. Okay. Next thing is text box. As you already know, just you can add any text in your workbook by using the text box option. Okay. Okay, let me delete it to show you the next thing. The next thing is header and footer. The content of header and footer repeats at the top and the bottom of each page respectively. This is very useful to show chapter name, page number, etc. As you already you have seen that the page number is in the bottom of each and every page in your book, or the chapter name is on the top of the page in your book, right? So that is called header and footer. By this section, you can add header and footer in your workbook. Okay. So that is all for the insert tab. Okay. Now I'm going to the next page layout tab. Okay, this is page layout tab. Just a moment. So the page layout tab, this is where it will change margins, paper size, orientation, define your print area, set page breaks, and specify which rows and columns will print on each page, and so on. So basically you can do all the necessary changes related with printing from the page layout tab. Okay. So you can change the margins. It can be normal, wide, or narrow depending on your requirement. Okay. Margins is actually giving more room on each page by expanding it. Okay. Just you can select normal, wide, or narrow. Okay. The next thing is orientation. If your data is wide, choose the landscape. Okay. If your data is wide, choose the landscape, because that is horizontally wider. If your data is tall, then choose portrait. Okay. So the next icon is size. From this icon, you can change the paper size. You can specify the paper size. Just like you already know that the paper sizes can be A4, can be A3, letter, or legal, or envelope. Okay. So you can change the paper size from here. Now, going to the print area. From this section, you can specify the actual printable area. For an example, I'm selecting this data. Okay. Now set print area. Okay. So this will, when I will print this data, only this thing will be printed, nothing else. Okay. So now the next thing is background. From this icon, you can add the background image. Let me show you. Work offline, then select a image, for an example this image, and click on insert. Okay, as you can see over here, I have added a background image like this. I have deleted it also, so you can add a background image. Okay, so that's all for the page layout tab. So I'm going to the data tab next, because about the formula tabs, I will have a entire session about the formula tabs. Okay, so please watch my session 5. It will describe the formulas. Okay, so I'm going to the data tab. In data tab, only two sections I will describe, that is sorting and filtering. So first start with the filter. Okay, okay, so first of all, before applying the filter, we must know what is filter. Okay, you can note it down. Filter is nothing but a technique to get the desired results, removing out the undesired ones. I repeat, filtering is nothing but a technique to get the desired results, removing out the undesired ones. Just have a look on this worksheet. Okay, it is having the data of a particular semester for each and every department. Okay, so but I want to show you only the name of the students from the tourism department. So how can I do that? Just let me show you the steps. I want to apply the filter on the column D. So selecting the column D, clicking on the on this filter icon, look over here. When I clicked the filter icon, a down arrow appeared in column D. Okay, just click on this arrow. Okay, so you will get this dialog box. Okay, now deselect all. I repeat, deselect all. Then just click on tourism and click on OK. Now have a look. Only the name of the students from tourism department is on your screen. Okay. So if I clear the filter, if I want to clear the filter, I will have to click on this icon, clear filter. Okay, now see. Okay, so this is all about filter. Now I will show you how to sort a data. Okay, how to sort a data. As you can see in this table, the name of the students, are not alphabetically sorted. Now let's make it sorted. Here are the steps. Click on C because I want to sort this column. Click on sort icon, then expand the selection. There is two button over here. So just click on expand the selection, just because to select the entire table. Otherwise, the values of the other columns will not change accordingly, and that will be a mess. Okay, so click on, then click on sort. Then you will have to sort by student name, cell values A to Z, and click on this my data has headers, because my table has headers. Okay, so click on, just tick on this, checkbox and click on OK. Look over here. You got the output. The name are alphabetically sorted now, right? Okay, so that is, I'm just undoing it. Okay, so that is all for the sorting, guys. Okay, so I have completed the data tab. Now going to the next tab, that is review. That is review. So from review tab, you can check the spelling and grammar. You can use the thesaurus. You can check the words. Okay. So just let me show you. Check the spelling. Over here in your workbook, there are three words, good, bad, and average. And just check the, I have done the spelling of the average deliberately. I have mistaken. Okay. So just checking the spelling. Look, you will get the correct spelling of average and just change. Click on yes. Okay. Now you can see that the spelling of average has been changed and now it is correct. Now what is thesaurus? You can actually, by clicking thesaurus, you can get the nearest meaning of the selected word. For an example, I have selected this word, this cell, and the cell contains bad. Okay, and by clicking thesaurus, I got the nearest meaning, evil, wicked, corrupt, or whatever. Okay, so from this tab, from the review tab, you can protect your worksheet also like this. Just put the password over here and click on OK. Then you can, so that you can protect your worksheet. Okay, it will be a password protected worksheet. Okay, so that is all for review tab. Okay, so I'm going to next tab, that is view tab. View tab actually allows you to for different views. Okay, just a moment, let me show you. Here are four views. You can see normal, page break, this is page break view, page layout, custom. Okay, so I'm going back to normal view. So these are the views, and you can also zoom, that is suppose 200%. I have selected 200% and click on OK. So you can see the changes. Okay, so by clicking on 100%, now your zoom is 100%. Okay, suppose I have selected this area and zoom to selection. Okay, now you can see the enlarged version of it. Okay, one more thing I will have to discuss, that is freezing panes. By this actually we can freeze our top row or top column or first column. Okay, so freeze top row. What will happen now? Just look at that. Okay, you can also freeze this column also. Okay, so I'm unfreezing the panes. Okay, so that is all for the today, students. See you in the next session, that is the formula session, and please don't miss it. Okay, stay at home, stay safe. Bye bye.